Good morning everyone. As we all know, today's group discussion topic is budget and its highlights. As we all know, Article 22-66 of our Constitution lays emphasis on consolidated fund of India, which says that government can not transact any amount without the permission of Parliament. And Article 112 of our Constitution talks about the budget. Whereas budget is not mentioned in the constitution, it has been said as the annual financial statements. As we all know, last year we have completed 75 years of our independence. On that day, our Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi said about the beginning of the Amrit Kal. This year's budget is the first budget of Amrit Kal. So I invite you all to talk about
the budget. As we know, the budget has been introduced on 1 February and the borrowing is estimated around 27.2 lakh crore and the expenditure is around 40 lakh crore. And this time we are having the 7 priorities. Out of that, the first priority is reaching the last miles. That means the government this time has focused on the regional development. There will be no imbalance in the economy. There will be regional growth in the economy in the rural areas also. And the second one is youth power. As you know that India is having one of the largest population and the ratio of the human resource is also greater. So by increasing the efficiency of the human resource, we can increase our GDP growth.
And other four bits are financial sector. So in this year, government has focused on the financial sector, in which government has decided to make the financial sector more stable and for green growth. Green growth means to focus on sustainable development, to use the green energy more.
Yeah, like you have mentioned the 7 pillars that government said that this time our budget will be focused on 7 priorities or 7 pillars. Out of which first is reaching the last mile and the second is youth power and other two that like you have mentioned, out of which one is green growth. So this time in our budget, government has focused more on green growth. Like government has launched many of the policies or many new schemes that government has come with, like a PM Pranam Yojana is there, and also the government said this time they wish that they have a vision that they will focus on making the economy as a technology driven. Like they want the population to use more and more technology to for sustainable development, also the economy growth, and also they focus that our economy should be knowledge-based. And the green growth, the government said that 500 new plants will be opened, which will be waste-to-wealth plants, like how we can use the waste to waste, like the agriculture extractions jo bach jata hai, unko hum use kaise kar sakte hain, to uske liye government 500 new plants set up karegi. And also there is clean plant program. Clean plant program basically means ki government farmers ko support karegi ki wo kaise fertilizers use na kare, unke badle kuch aur unka substitute use kare, jisse ki hamare jo fruits and vegetable hai wo fertilizer free ho sake. And also there is government is focusing on the unleashing the potential, like jahan pe bhi hamari economy ke andar potential hai hum har jagah usko use kare. Like हमने ये देखा कि 2023 को ऑफिशियली इंटरनेशनल ईयर ऑफ मिलेट्स अनाउंस किया गया है. इंडिया है वो इंडिया इज वर्ल्ड्स लार्जेस्ट प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ मिलेट्स एंड आल्सो सेकंड लार्जेस्ट एक्सपोर्टर ऑफ मिलेट्स. सो गवर्नमेंट इज फोकसिंग एंड आल्सो दिस टाइम इन द G20 समिट दैट इंडिया विल बी ऑर्गेनाइजिंग, इंडिया विल मेनली फोकसिंग ऑन फ्लोरिशिंग ग्रोथ ऑफ मिलेट्स. लाइक दे विल बी प्रमोटिंग मिलेट्स, क्योंकि हमारे यहाँ पे मिलेट्स बहुत ज्यादा है, तो इससे दो प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व होगी. एक तो हमारे यहाँ पे जो हंगर की जो प्रॉब्लम है कि कोई भी हर किसी को फूड ग्रेन्स मिल सके, तो उसके लिए भी हम मिलेट्स को प्रमोट करेंगे. ऑल्सो मिलेट्स की जो कॉस्ट है, मिलेट्स की जो कॉस्ट होती है वो बहुत कम होती है, तो और बहुत सारे लोगों के लिए ईजिली अवेलेबल हो जाएगा फूड.
Budget is the combination of incomes and expenditures, and income expenditure will be in the two sense, capital expenditure and remaining expenditure, and in the other side, capital income and remaining income. Where the capital means regular, not regular in nature, irregular in nature, and remaining means the expenses and incomes which are defensive sector for the growth and development of the country and its people. And growth and development are the two basic points. If we took an example of a person, growth is something which is related to his height, weight, and body structure. And development is basically to its mentally development. So this is the main concept of budget.
Yeah, the budget involves some changes in tax level exams. Just in old budget, we have to pay tax above the 5 lakh of income. But in new budget, we have to pay tax above the 7 lakh of income. So the tax deduction is 25% from 25% from 37%, and there are some tax reduces on electronic items, but charges on like kitchen chimney, cigarettes, and many more. And
I totally agree with all of you, but all these points are important, but we are missing one major point, that is our total expenditure is expected to be 45 lakh crores and total borrowings are expected to be 27.2 lakh crores this year.
This is a huge amount.
This time that the government has focused more on the capital expenditure, that means that our infrastructure with our expenditure kiya jaye, jisse ki hamari jo employment rate is going to increase hogi aur hamari living standard bhi rise hoga.
Also the government is focusing ki is baar jaise ki last year hamare India ke andar bahut sare startups ne rise kiya tha, jisme se kafi sare unicorns bhi bane the, but there is a fact ki agriculture based startups corona time ke andar bahut sare startups ko paisa nahi mil raha tha, but phir bhi government focus kar rahi thi and funding kar rahi thi agri based startups ko, but phir bhi unme se koi bhi startup unicorn nahi ban paya. To is baar ke budget mein hamari jo finance minister hai unhone kaha hai ki hum और ज्यादा फंडिंग करेंगे एग्री टेक बेस्ड स्टार्टअप्स.
या आई लाइक टू क्लियर, जैसे प्रियंका ने बताया कि स्टार्टअप पे गवर्नमेंट कर रही है, तो पहले उसकी लिमिट थी 2 करोड़ रुपए और अब उसकी लिमिट कर दी गई 3 करोड़ रुपए, और जो कवरअप था लॉसेस का, लॉस सर्टेन करने का, वो पहले था 7 ईयर और अब उसको बढ़ा के 10 साल कर दी गई.
आई टोटली एग्री विद ऑल ऑफ यू. गवर्नमेंट हैज आल्सो रेडी पेसेस ऑन दी हेल्थ सेक्टर. Their government has taken a decision to set up 157 new nursing colleges and had laid a mission to eliminate sickle cell anemia by 2047.
Like we have talked much about the agriculture and the health, we have two points announced here, just like 157 new nursing colleges खोले जाएंगे जो हमारे फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर ने कहा है इस बार के बजट में, एंड ऑल्सो सिंगल सेल एनीमिया भी एलिमिनेट करा जाएगा. बट इसके अलावा भी एक पॉइंट है एजुकेशन. पिछली बार जो हमारा बजट आया था उसके अंदर 2.8% हमारा जीडीपी का वो कंट्रीब्यूट कर रहा था, और इस बार भी उसके अंदर कोई ज्यादा चेंजेस नहीं किए गए. इस बार का जो कंट्रीब्यूशन है एजुकेशन का वो है 2.9%, जिसका मेजर रीजन है कि इस बार गवर्नमेंट ने कुछ एक्स्ट्रा स्टार्ट नहीं किया है, बस एक दो स्कीम चाहिए जैसे कि एकलव्य योजना, एकलव्य मॉडल स्कूल है जो कि ट्राइबल यूजर है उनके लिए खोले जाएंगे, जैसे कि नवोदय होते हैं जो कि हॉस्टल बेस्ड स्कूल एजुकेशन होती है, वही वैसी ही एक सिस्टम एकलव्य मॉडल स्कूल के नाम से स्टार्ट किया जाएगा, जिसके अंदर ट्राइबल पीपल के जो बच्चे हैं उनको एजुकेशन प्रोवाइड करेंगे.
Become cheaper and on the
7 lakh income and exempt it. But they are government is giving us both of the options. We can file our returns on the old design also and the new design also, because there are some benefits in the old design also, because in the old design there are sales tax of 3000 and also it is deduction in 1 lakh 3000. So there are the it gives the motivation to the person who is filing the returns to give the to induce more investments in the other things. But in the new design there are no scope of investments, so a person can file it in the old design also and new design also.
As before, Nipun has talked about research and development. This time, the government, comparison and last year, the government is research and development mein bahut kam expenditure kiya hai. Lekin hamari country mein jo private sector hai, wo bahut kam expenditure kar raha hai research and development pe. So the government has also reduced it. But I think the government has to increase this for the next year, because jo many developed countries hai, wo bahut zyada expenditure kar rahe hai research and development.
I agree with Priyanka, as she said that our private sector is investing very less amount in research and development sector. As we see in other economies, private sector invests more in research and development, but public sector provides less for research and development. But in our economy, if we see in our economy, private sector is investing less in R&D sector, but public sector is investing more. So to increase for that, public sector has also come forward for investing in research and development sector for its growth.
Also, in our budget, the government has come up with a new term like ease of doing business, for which our finance minister said that we have reduced 39,000 compliances under which you have आपके पास एक कंपल्शन जाती है, अगर आप इन कंप्लाइंसेस के अंदर आते हैं तो आपको जेल हो सकती है. बट अब उनको रिड्यूस कर दिया गया है, जिसकी वजह से ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस और ज्यादा बढ़ गया है. एंड ऑल्सो द गवर्नमेंट इज फोकसिंग ऑन प्रमोटिंग लैब बेस्ड गाइडेंस, मतलब जिनके लैब बेस्ड गाइडेंस को और ज्यादा प्रमोट किया जाएगा इसका.
In our budget, the government has allocated for investment on building new infrastructure as 50 new airports, helipads and water heliports are also made. And apart from these 50 tourist destinations, among all India is to be selected to make India a tourist destination.
Also, the government has a green hydrogen mission, like we are much relied on fossil fuels for energy, our energy needs. Now, government, most of the developed economies are focused on hydrogen energy, like they don't use fossil fuels much, but they use hydrogen as an energy resource. So, India is also focusing that we will use in future hydrogen energy.
Government is trying very hardly to use alternate source of energy, because fossil fuels are very dangerous to our health and creating pollution in our country. So government cannot do anything against the government neither. But we also need to have handling him and we contribute 100% of ourselves, then our India will be
I totally agree with Nipun, as he said ki fossil fuels mein health hazards hote hain. बट इसका एक अलग पॉइंट ये भी है कि इससे हमारे कैपिटल डेफिसिट में इंक्रीज होता है. अगर हम खुद इंडिया में कोई फ्यूल वगैरह बनाएंगे तो हमको बाहर से इंपोर्ट नहीं करना पड़ेगा, और हम अपनी कंट्री का ही उसमें ब्लेंड करके खुद के जो इंपोर्ट का अमाउंट है उसको कम कर सकते हैं.
So I would like to conclude that in this year's budget, the government has focused on agriculture and many other priority sectors. But there is more need to focus on research and development and also on education to make India Atmanirbhar.
Yes, also
government also doing like that. Use lithium-ion battery for in mobile phones and import camera lens. For dipping the quality and the use the ethyl alcohol for greenery chemical industries. So
and also expand on the health education board.